21, the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And welcome to our audience night service. There's no better place to be found than in the house of the Lord. You definitely want to end well and begin well at the same time in the house of the Lord among the saints with Jesus. Amen. Thank you.
Father, we thank you for the past year, dear God. We thank you for keeping us together. We thank you, God, the health and strength provided for us, dear Jesus. Father, tonight, dear God, I lift up the service before you, dear God, tonight, dear Jesus. I lift up the song leaders, the backups, the musician. And most of all, dear God, as your one servant, bring forth the word, dear God. You would take it through our hearts tonight, dear Jesus. Father, tonight we depend on you for everything in our lives tonight, dear Jesus. Father, you know everything about each and every one of us, dear Lord. We know aches, we know pains, we know needs, dear God. Father, tonight I pray for each one of us, every member of our church, I bring them before you, dear God. Keep us, dear God, together.
Yes.
Bind us, dear God. Give us the strength and the courage, dear God. Help us, dear Jesus, to cry out, Abba, Father, tonight, dear God. Father, tonight I pray for this year that you will be soon approaching, dear God. I pray, God, that you pour on your blessings upon us tonight, dear God. Help us never to give up. Trust you for everything in our lives tonight. Father, tonight I pray for those who cannot make it tonight, dear God, that you will be with them. You keep them under your precious blood tonight, dear Jesus. Father, I lift them all communities before you, my high for dear God. Governor Road, dear God, South Road, dear Jesus. I pray, God, you keep all our members together, God. And Father, we look forward for great things in this year, God. We pray, Lord, God, as we have vision for the coming year, dear God. Everything will be done, pleasing unto you, dear God. Continue to provide for us, continue to give us health and strength tonight, dear Jesus. I pray, dear God, in a special way for those among us, dear God, who are not feeling too good, too well, dear God. I pray, God, that you touch us in a special way tonight, dear Jesus. Father, our school is opening very soon, dear God. I bring the school children before you, dear God. Protect them, dear God, in the schools. Protect them in the maxis and the taxis, dear God.
Yes.
Be with them, dear Jesus. Father, I lift up our protective services before you tonight, dear Jesus. The policemen, dear God, the firemen, the doctors, the nurses, dear God, as they do their jobs. Guide and protect them, dear God. Be with them. Even those in the hospital at this time, dear God, I pray, God, that you would send ministers, angels, to speak to them and give them comfort tonight, dear Jesus. Father, we want to thank you, praise you, and tell you how much you love you and appreciate you tonight, dear Jesus. Father, tonight I bring all saved loved ones before you, dear God. You know them, dear God. You promise us whole soul salvation, dear God. And I pray, God, that they would come to know you before it is too late, dear God. Father, I lift up those of backsliders, dear God, who have stopped coming to church tonight, dear God. I pray, God, that you will talk to them before it is too late, dear Jesus. We thank you and we praise you, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray with thanksgiving. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. From the rising of the sun to the setting of the same, the name of the Lord is to be praised. The people will be gathered all over our country, different places, places of pleasure, places of entertainment. But you have chosen the best place, and that is to be in the house of the Lord. And I trust that this desire will continue throughout the year to dwell in the house of the Lord.
Thank you.
verse taken from Ecclesiastes 3:1. To everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heavens. Isaiah 43:18 and 19. Forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I am making a way in the wilderness and a stream in the wasteland. Psalms 19:12. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you, and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Proverbs 6:9. In his heart a man's plan his course, but the Lord determines his step. Philippians 3:13-14. Brothers and sisters, I do not consider myself yet to have taken hold of it. But one thing I do, forgetting what is behind and staring towards what is ahead, I press on towards the goal to win the prize for which God has called me heavenward in Christ Jesus. Psalms 65:11. Your crown the year with your bounty, and your cart overflows with abundance. Second Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. The old has gone, the new is here. 1 Peter 1:3. Praise be to God and Father, our Lord Jesus Christ. In his great mercy, he has given us a new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. Proverbs 3:5-6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to him, and he will make your path straight. Isaiah 40:31. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. Amen.
Amen. Thank God for the reading of this word. My encouragement to all of us, you know, as our pastor already here, let us know the theme for 2023 is God is saying that you need to trust me. Proverbs 3:5-6, trust in the Lord. So many times we want to lean to our own understanding or the things that we can see, the things that are tangible. But I tell you people, the things that you cannot see is more real than what we can see.
Amen.
So pray that that God give each and every one of us the strength to open up our spiritual eyes and to see that he is sovereign, that he is in control.
Amen.
And whatever we may face, whatever we may go through, God is going to work it out for our good. We only need to trust in him.
Amen.
This time I have a special song by Abigail. even if we live longer than that, 200 years old, anybody want to live to 200? Not many persons, hardships, hard times. But even no matter how long we live, God's goodness, it keeps running after us over and over. It cannot exhaust itself. That is the goodness of our God. He is faithful and He is true. This evening as we continue, I have my young brother Brandon. He's going to come and play for us this evening. So while he is setting up, there's going to have a couple of us in front here who received promises. So for those of you who have not received a promise, please let the ushers know they are distributing them at the front, and hold on to these verses and see how God is going to work in and through it. Study it, learn it, memorize the verse, and claim God's promise in your life. So on the card, it's just a promise that is listed, but there's a verse. The verse attached, you can go and get the entire verse and go more in depth into it. So tonight, I'd like to share my promise, and it's from Ezekiel 36, 26 to 27. And the promise from those verses are, I have given you a new heart and put my own spirit in you. I have given you a new heart and put my own spirit in you. I am just excited to see how God is going to make this promise just come alive in my life. I can tell that it's already there, you know, but just to see it unfold, I'm going to ask Sister Iva, and I'm going to ask Dinesh as well, Sister Manisa, if you could also share your promises. I'm going to give the rest of you an opportunity later on in our service. But first, we're going to hear from Brandon. He is ready.
You have to say to me. Last year my promise was about that God would bless me. I would not have room to contain, and He kept His promise. You know, last year was such a blessing. I had to share with so many times. You received many things whom I had to share with my neighbors, and I thank God for His faithfulness. This time my promise is from 2 Samuel chapter 22 verse 33 and 34. They say, I will give you strength to help you stand in high places. God knows that I need strength in this time that we are living in. You know, last year was a real tough year, a real challenging year. Every day go by was a challenge, but I thank God for strength. I thank God for victory. I thank God for deliverance. I thank God for working in a mighty way. And I thank God for my church family. You hard workers that God has placed here. I give God praise for you. And may God continue to bless you richly. Give you strength to continue to run this race. It's not for the swift. It's not for the strong. It's for those that are endure to the end. So saints, don't give up. Continue to fight the good fight of faith. Thank God for strength tonight.
My promise is coming from Hebrews 13:5. I will never abandon you. And this is a true promise, not only to me, but to everyone here in this house tonight. So just always remember that He will never leave us nor forsake us. So just continue to press on and keep on remembering that God is always with us. Amen.
I will not let you be tested beyond what you can endure. And this is like the saying, He doesn't give you more than you can handle. And God knows your limits, and He knows how much you can take, and really doesn't give you more than you can really handle. So, you know, I will hold this promise true to my heart, and you know, I will be looking forward to whatever test that you have for me this year. So, amen.
Amen.
Thank you all for sharing with us, and Manisa, God really going to give you patience. You know where you live, you have a lot of patience. You're going to need help on both sides. He's not going to give you more than you can handle. I know sometimes with the daily grind of life, you know, you want to give up, you want to quit, you want to pelt at something, you know, but God is, you know, He's going to give you the strength and He's going to carry us through. Last evening, Christmas, actually, you know, it is traditional in our church that we normally go around caroling, singing, you know, just having a good time and a good fellowship with the saints, with the believers. And this year was no different. And each time I think it gets better. And I really thank God for the warm hearts that we have here at Power and Science Ministries. We can go to anyone's home and just feel so comfortable. And I thank God for what He is doing in our church family. So we do, some of you would have seen the live videos, but we have put together a little video this evening. For those of you who missed out or you couldn't join us, at least you can have a little bit of the fun. So you can look to the screen and see the video of some of the things that took place on that evening.
She had a mom, she was poor, come here.
Break time after for those of you who need to refresh yourself, something to drink, something.